Hello, today we're going to take a trip back to an ancient Coliseum where they used to have all sorts of games. This is the Coliseum in Rome, Italy, because it is still there, it is still standing. There was a Coliseum in Greece, it is there, but it's mostly looks like a stadium now with just the seats going down to a stage in the middle. This is a very large brick building, and it's very ancient and very big. If you look over here on this side, you see part of the top of the Colosseum is missing. That's because the famous Napoleon Bonaparte decided that his soldiers should use the Colosseum as target practice. So therefore, part of the top of the Coliseum is missing. And that's what's going to make drawing this so much fun. These are the colors that we're going to use. Now you can use whatever colors you want, but during the afternoon sun, the Coliseum itself does look quite orange. I know I was there just this past fall, and it is a lovely, breathtaking sight. So let's start with the brown, okay? You turn your paper horizontally. We're going to put the line down about 3/4 of the way down. And this is the line that our Coliseum is going to sit on. We're going to start on the left-hand side and just do a box with a kind of beat-up looking roof. Well, actually, it doesn't have a roof anymore. Thank you, Napoleon. And goes down like this, and you just do the very best that you can. There we go. Now there is a bit of masonry right in the middle. Makes it look sort of like a birthday cake, a layer cake. And it's very thin line. Actually, this is where the two floors are. Let's put in some of these long windows, okay? They're just squares. Make them as even with each other as you can. It is difficult, I know, with a pastel to make these exact, but just do the best you can, okay? You can just put as many as you want or as few as you want, just so long as you get an idea of what the Coliseum looked like. All right, down here are the doors, the entry doors. They're quite large. Like this, and one over here like this. Inside the door is the round arch where you walk through, okay? Essentially, we're through. So, let's make the colors. Let's start off with a bright orange. This is the side that the sun is going to be shining on, over here to the left. Now, if you remember about pastels, you remember that you can fill it in with your finger. So just do around the windows, and you can do it as slowly and carefully as you want, or you can do it quickly like I'm doing. We're going to put some dark brown on it too in just a minute, kind of tone it down. This is just a base coat. Don't cover up the windows or the doors, please. Okay. I think I got finished before some of my students. Okay, this is a darker orange. It's what we use to actually draw the Coliseum. So let's just put in a few touches. Over here is going to be darker because it's not so much in the sun. Just a few touches. Take your fingers and blend. See how quickly you've just made it nice and smooth. How about that? put some ground for this Coliseum to rest on. I like to make it look like there's kind of pathways coming up to this. Fill it in. Don't leave it hanging out there in the middle of the air, okay? Now, this is a beautiful sunny day. Let's start with the sky. Now look how great this looks with this orange Coliseum. That's because the aqua of the sky and the Coliseum's orange are complementary colors. Okay, we're just about finished. Got to put the sky inside the windows. Look at that, how it just lightens it up, and you almost feel like you're ready to see some games in there. Okay, now take your dark brown, and we're going to make it look really dark inside these entryways. Really dark. And you can put some details on it if you like. You can You get the idea. And when you're coming from this way, just showing it to you over here on this side. Okay. All right. Now, this is totally up to you. You can use your artistic bent if you like. Take some black and make some teeny little people walking around. They look like ants because this is a really big place. And you can actually even have a line of folks if you want to coming up to it. You just do what you like. You can put them inside the door. There they are going inside. It's very crowded here. Now, when you're all finished, be sure you sign your name in the corner, flip your picture over and name it and date it, and be sure that you show it to all of your whole family and your friends, because this is where they have held Olympic Games many, many, many years ago. What a great job you have done!